Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. The keyboard hobby has always been about variety, customization, and preference. But even though we live in a world where we're spoiled for choice, sometimes you can't find that one specific feature you're looking for or a solution to a problem you're having. For example, I'm sure we can all agree that there are so many amazingly designed keyboard bottoms out there. Just look at keyboards like the Zoom 65, Snake, and Tofu SE. Whether it's an engraving, weight, or custom artwork, they all go unseen during normal use because, of course, you can't see the bottom of your keyboard when you're typing. And I think that's a real shame because a lot of the personality of the keyboard can be expressed through the uniquely designed bottom. But that's just the sad reality of this situation, and I think there's a lot of wasted potential. So I wanted to bridge this disconnect of having an aesthetically designed bottom that I'm also able to appreciate and enjoy while typing. The answer to my problem was already sitting on my desk. One of the first keyboard upgrades I ever got was this one, a wooden wrist rest from Glorious. As time has gone by, I switched out everything in my peripheral setup besides this one component. I originally got it because I wanted to maintain a more proper typing posture. It may seem overly cautious, but typing actually causes strain on your hands that could lead to complications. When typing, you should be hovering your wrists in the air to mitigate this risk. And to be honest, hovering your wrist is fatiguing and unrealistic for long typing sessions or gaming. Often, people will instead place their wrist on the table, which is probably the worst position it could be in. By using a wrist rest, you're forcing your wrist to maintain a healthier raised position. I've always enjoyed the ergonomic benefits of using a wrist rest, and it just makes typing a more comfortable experience overall. By now, I'm sure you guys can see where I'm going with this. The solution to my problem was to simply include an accompanying wrist rest with the same design as the bottom of the keyboard. That way, the design isn't hidden away, and you can actually see it when it's sitting on your desk. I've had this idea for some time, and I'm really excited to show you guys my first ever keyboard design. Keep in mind this is still a prototype and things are subject to change, but it's at a point where I feel comfortable sharing it with everyone. If you have any feedback for me, please share it in the comments and I'll take it into consideration. And if you're as excited as I am, please consider subscribing to help support my channel, and share this video with a friend if you think they'll enjoy it too. Before I could get started, I first needed to settle on some basic measurements. For reference, I used a bunch of these 65% keyboards in my collection and got a ballpark idea of how big everything should be. I then took those dimensions and created some hand drawings to start my design. These measurements haven't been updated yet, and when I made the switch to 3D modeling, the design of course changed slightly, so most of these numbers aren't accurate anymore. The one design component I was sure to keep consistent was for every angle to be at 7 degrees. You can call it an Easter egg or just consistent branding, but I am level 7 Kevin, so I thought it would be a fun nod. I came across some useful websites that I used to design the plate and import it into Fusion 360. Of course, I'll leave these websites linked in the description for you to check out as well. My favorite keyboard layout is 65%, so that's the one I picked. They made generating this CAD model of the plate super quick and easy. For the PCB, I decided not to design my own custom PCB and instead use the DZ65. This is the same PCB used in the Tofu 65 by KBD fans. I've used several of these in the past and I'm very comfortable working with it. Also looking online, it looks like there are other PCBs that use the same form factor as this one. But because I haven't tested any of these myself, I can't officially say if these will be compatible with my keyboard or not. The main design element is this weight, which will simply show the name of the board. Because I have not picked a finalized name, I use prototype 01 as a placeholder. The letters will poke through the bottom of the board, giving it a nice two-tone look. The exact same weight piece will also be fitted into the wrist rest, where it will be predominantly displayed. Because this is my first time designing a keyboard, I decided to go with a top mount. It's generally considered a better mounting style than tray or bottom mount and doesn't require the massive amount of work that gasket mount does. Here you can see how the plate and top case fit together. Then the top case is secured to the bottom. This took me a long time to complete, and I'm really happy with how the final design turned out. It's minimal and familiar, but the wrist rest gives it that extra design element that it needs. I do have to work out some minor elements like deciding on silicone feet, but things like that won't require any major design modifications. And here's a render of everything put together. I want to make this project collaborative with you guys, so please share your feedback with me in the comments. Especially if you have ideas for a cool name, that would help out a lot. I'm sure the biggest question you have is if this keyboard will be available for purchase in the future. So here's my timeline of steps I need to take in order to get there. Step 1 is already done, which is designing the first prototype. Step 2 will be to get the design 3D printed so I can make sure all my dimensions are correct. I have been 3D printing some slices of the keyboard, but because the bed size of my printer isn't big enough, I'm not able to make prints in full size. This step is going to be important specifically for making sure the USB-C port is properly aligned with the PCB. Right now, this slice shows that it is, but triple checking never hurt anyone. Next, I would make any design changes necessary, including finalizing the name for the board and taking into consideration any feedback you have for me. Again, if you have any name suggestions right now, please let me know by sharing them in the comments. During this time, I'll also have two aluminum prototypes manufactured. Of course, one of them will be for me to keep, but the other will be used as the keyboard for the next episode of Animech. I'm sure a lot of you guys know me for that series, and the client is actually a personal friend of mine. He's been waiting patiently basically since I started this channel, and now that I have my own keyboard design, I can make something truly special. To end the timeline will be the interest check and group buy. But as you guys can see, there's going to be a lot of steps before we get there. I'll be documenting this project right here on YouTube, so you'll always be able to see how far along I am. I've never tried to run my own group buy before, so if you have any advice when it comes to manufacturing, interest checks, group buys, websites, vendors, etc., please get into contact with me and share any advice you have. Again, everything is completely new to me, so any advice helps. Remember to subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and consider becoming a channel member if you'd like to support me directly. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.